13th in Roar, West Virginia. Come see West Virginia Championship Wrestling's Fall Brawl 2013. On the card features a tag team championship grudge match featuring the Universal Heartthrobs against champions Old School Elite. Witness a return 20 years in the making as Mr. Number One George South returns to McDowell County. The Mighty Hojo battles J.C. Dykes Jr. as the war rages on. Matches are a part of the Downtown Street Festival. Admission is completely free. Bell time, 6 p.m. See you September 13th in Roar, West Virginia.
Seven.
Out of seven, ladies and gentlemen.
I said eight.
Wait a minute. That's it.
Are you serious? Are you serious?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a double count.
Who's the champion? Are you serious?
They won't even stay on the ring.
Go tell Kurt to get involved, and I'm going to come get Kurt off of him.
Really, yes. Cody?
Oh, there's definitely something going on under the ring.
Under the ring?
What's that? Wait a minute. On the near side of the camera.
Oh, here's JC, Cody, Randy, and whoa, I'm confused.
Where's it? Is Hojo under there? And Hojo comes out.
Wow!
Comes out from under the ring, and JC goes right back onto the attack. This match is over.
And Cody Green walks away.
He shrugs his shoulders.
Cody Green just walks away.
This is garbage. This is absolute garbage. I can't say what I want to say because we're on national television, but this is absolute garbage. The referee just walks off and shrugs his shoulders. What kind of horse crap is that? He needs to be ensuring the safety of these men. Now, damn it. You need to get over there and do something. Oh, and they got the powder. Yeah, nice way to keep order there, senior ref. About damn time somebody did something. Somebody agreed with Set, and now they're out there helping Hojo. Good job, Eric St. Clair. Good job. That's not only world class, that's first class. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we got for this week. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I've just been informed that on August 10th, back here at the Princeton Rec Center, for the WVCW Television Championship, J.C. Dykes Jr. and the mighty Hojo. What? What? The nation is speaking.
So I'm assuming you want a street fight. I got an idea. Here we go. This will be good. You're the senior official around here. I'm not sure why, because you don't officiate anything. I never thought I'd ever want Eric Foster back to ref. I got a lot of them. We got to settle this TV title situation. JC and Hojo have earned it. They're going to have to fight for it again. Here's my vote. I vote we give them a street fight that they want to see. And I'll make it under this consideration, Mr. Senior Official. We're going to keep it straight and keep it right. Handcuff me to Kurt Taylor. That way he can't do anything to alter the outcome of that match.
I want one more thing. I want every door in this gymnasium locked, chained, whatever. I don't want him able to run from me. I don't want him to be able to get away. I want, it's not just a street fight. I want falls to count anywhere in here. If I catch him over by that door and I break his neck, I want to be able to pin him right there.
All right, you got it. August 10th, falls count anywhere. Street fight, handcuffed together. We'll settle this once and for all.
Do you love to eat? Do you love to celebrate cultures from around the world? Then join us, St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church, on Saturday, September 21st for the World Food Festival. The World Food Festival is an annual event of the parish, and it celebrates various cultures represented in the church. It's an opportunity to present food, music, traditional dress of these cultures to the community. The church is located above US 460, just west of the Route 52 intersection. Purchase your tickets now in advance at a discounted rate by contacting 304-308-0274. We look forward to seeing you at the World Food Festival, September 21st at St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church.
Great series of matches. It's called The Best of the 80s, Volume 1, from Southwest Championship Wrestling. Some of the best wrestling there ever was during the 80s. Some of the best wrestling ever.
Is none other than Ward Wilson. Now, Ward Wilson was a wrestling fan who had dreams of being in the wrestling industry. Little did he know that he would leave his mark and his place in the history of Southern West Virginia. Ward was responsible for the creation in November of 1999 of Appalachia Pro Wrestling, one of the most memorable and successful promotions in this region. Later, after APW closed down, Ward became a referee working with numerous promotions around Southern West Virginia until its untimely death in 2009. Ward, I know for all of us here at WVCW, we miss you each and every day, and we cannot be more honored than to induct you into the WVCW Hall of Fame. Fans, let's go take a look at Ward Wilson right now.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
fans. Joining me now, Scotty Blaze, on this special Hall of Fame episode. And Scotty, I wanted to grab you for a minute and let you talk about a man that me and you both know, former APW promoter and former referee, Mr. Ward Wilson.
Well, Ward, first of all, let me say, we all miss you, my friend. And June, his wife, she's been like a sister to me, believe it or not. And this is a straight shoot. You know, this isn't Scotty Blaze talking. June's birthday and my son's birthday are the exact same day. And ever since my son was born back in 1999, they, both of them, June and Ward, treated me like family. They showered my son with gifts. His first, I remember, that's one of my favorite memories of them. My son's very first year birthday, all right? We go up to Oak Hill for the show for APW. It's a Tuesday night. And I can't remember if he'd already had his birthday or if his birthday is upcoming. But June and Ward gave us so many gifts. And back then, you know, because I was a father, I had a Ford Taurus, four-door, you know, ooh, big champion riding a four-door. But nah, they gave us so many gifts for my son that we barely got all the doors shut. The trunk I had to sit on. And back then, I was 350 pounds. It took a lot of pushing. But Ward Wilson, I'm going to tell you what, I will always be indebted to you for letting me be a part of some of my favorite memories, which was APW. The Tuesday night shows in Oak Hill, I mean, they were phenomenal. We were drawing, what, two plus 100 every Tuesday night? That was unheard of on a Tuesday night, weekly. And because of Ward Wilson, he let me be a part of that. And I got to be a part of something great. I was just a small cog in a very big machine. And we had great talent. I mean, we had the War Machine. We had the Urban Death Squad. Johnny Blast, Spider Crawley, Brian Douglas there, Joey Morton, Danny Ray. I mean, who don't love Danny Ray? I mean, all these wonderful talents. And people came in and wanted to be part of APW. And that tells you why APW is special. Because everybody everywhere wanted to be part of APW. And part of that magic was because of Ward Wilson. When I heard of Ward's passing, I did. I sat down and cried because I lost a friend. And an important part of wrestling history for the southern part of West Virginia had lost a great man. And he truly was a great man. Ward, much love to you. Hope you're looking down on us. I'll see you when I get there, my friend. And June, you've always been like a sister to me. I love you.
Let me tell you, Ward Wilson, you are not missed at all. We love you, remember you, we respect you, and it is on my honor to present this to Dangerous Dave Scott, who had one of the greatest opportunities of a lifetime to be there with Ward in his final days. And he passed away in 2009 right here in this very building, and we miss you, Ward. We love you, but right now, you, my friend, you have earned a top seat in the Class of 2012 WVCW Hall of Fame. Ward Wilson, congratulations to you. Dave, would you like to have any comments you'd like to say on Ward Wilson's behalf?
You know, 12 years ago when I started this journey in this business, there's a lot of times I didn't have the money to make it to the training centers, to the shows. Ward Wilson dug into his own pocket and made sure that I had the cash to get trained to do this business that I've loved so much for 12 years. Ward, I know you're listening. All of this behind you is a dedication to what you were to this company, to this business. It all started with APW. It all started with you, and all of us here love you from the bottom of our hearts. So on behalf of June Wilson, the whole Ward Wilson family, we love you, brother.
Thank you very much, Dave. Fans,
Spotlight. Do you love to celebrate cultures from around the world? Then join us, St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church, on Saturday, September 21st for the World Food Festival. The World Food Festival is an annual event of the parish, and it celebrates various cultures represented in the church. It's an opportunity to present food, music, traditional dress of these cultures to the community. The church is located above US 460, just west of the Route 52 intersection. Purchase your tickets now in advance at a discounted rate by contacting 304-308-0274. We look forward to seeing you at the World Food Festival, September 21st, at St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church.
I've said a lot of bad things to you people, and I've done a lot worse in my life, but me and Roger didn't deserve that. I've been a low-down, no-good snake most of my life, and I plan to keep on being it. But never again will I be jumped from behind from a no-good dog like Joey Morton and Dave Scott and that old coward, Danny Ray. I promise you, Roger, next week on this television, next week I said, make it happen. I want Dave Scott. I want Joey Morton. I want them in this ring.
Since we've been here, that's all we've done is make statements. And finally, after all this time, we had to beat Matt Hardy and Shane Helms to get a shot at the titles here at WVCW. So I tell you what, we're going to start a new process here. We're going to start something. We're going to call it Old School Elites Broken Bone Society. It's real simple to start that out. Anybody gets in the ring, something is broken, something is injured, something is damaged. It starts right now.
Joey Morton, what's going on? Wait a minute, there's a roll up. One, two, no.
Only a count of two.
That was almost going to be a count of three, but wasn't for David Scott. Rip Manson now going after Danny Ray. Going on over here,
ladies and gentlemen. Rip Manson, he's getting Manson taped around the pole. And the way the referee needs to, turn around. Just turn to your left, Andrew.
And that's it. Roger Ham had the tap. We got new tag team champions, people, in the Old School Elite.
By God, Morton, the Old School Elite.
Standing up because the ground ain't no place for a champion. You hear me talking? Joey Morton, Dave Scott, the next time I see you in this ring, payback's gonna be coming. Like I said before, I've done a lot of bad stuff in my day. Some things I'm proud of, some I'm not. I'm about to do something I'm real proud of.
But the landscape of WVCW has, oh my God.
It looks like the landscape's going to get tore up even more. As Danny Ray puts a figure four on Rip Manson and the, oh, come on, guys. They did the same thing to the leg
of Roger
Ham a few weeks ago, and now they're.
Friday, September 13th in War, West Virginia. Come see West Virginia Championship Wrestling's Fall Brawl 2013. On the card features a tag team championship grudge match featuring the Universal Heartthrobs against champions Old School Elite. Witness a return 20 years in the making as Mr. Number One George South returns to McDowell County. The Mighty Hojo battles J.C. Dykes Jr. as the war rages on. Matches are a part of the Downtown Street Festival. Admission is completely free. Bell time, 6 p.m. See you September 13th in War, West Virginia. To eat? Do you love to celebrate cultures from around the world? Then join us, St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church, on Saturday, September 21st for the World Food Festival. The World Food Festival is an annual event of the parish, and it celebrates various cultures represented in the church. It's an opportunity to present food, music, traditional dress of these cultures to the community. The church is located above US 460, just west of the Route 52 intersection. Purchase your tickets now in advance at a discounted rate by contacting 304-308-0274. We look forward to seeing you at the World Food Festival, September 21st at St. Mary's Orthodox Christian Church.
I am the thorn in the foot. I am the blur in the sight. I am the worm at the root. I am the rat in the wall, the leper that leers at the gate. I am the ghost in the hall, peril of horror at hate. I am the rust on the corn, I am the smut on the wheat. Laughing men's labor to scorn, weaving a web for his feet. I am canker and mildew and blight, danger and death and decay. The rot of the rain by night, the blast of the sun by day. I warp and wither with drought, I work in the swamps far east, I bring the black plague from the south, and the leprosy in from the east. I rent from the hemlock boughs, the wine steeped in the petals of doom, where the fat black serpents drowse, I gather the upas bloom. I have plumbed the northern ice for a spell like frozen lead, in lost grey fields of rice. I have learned from Mongol dead what a bleak black mountain stands. I have looted grisly caves. I have digged in the desert sands to plunder terrible graves. And never the sun goes forth, never the moon glows red, but out of the south or the north I come with the slavering dead. I come with hideous spells, black trance and ghastly tunes. I have looted the hidden hells and plundered the lost black moons. There was never a king or priest to cheer me by word or look. There was never a man or beast in the blood-black ways I took. There were crimson gulfs unplumbed and black wings of us. There were pits where mad things drummed in foaming blasphemy. There were vast ungodly tombs where slime monsters streamed. There were clouds like blood-drenched plumes where unborn demons screamed. There were ages dead to time. And lands lost out of space. There were adders in the slime, and a dim, unholy face. Oh, the heart in my breast turned stone, and the brain froze in my skull. But I went through, I alone, and poured my chalice full of horrors and dooms and spells, black buds and bitter roots. From the hells beneath the hells, I bring you my deadly fruits.